Rocking. Okay. Hello, friends. Looks like it's working. I'm going to just double check and make sure that we are live on YouTube. I don't need to make a tab group today. Thank you very much. Let's see here. And yeah, okay, cool. We're live on YouTube, so that's wonderful. I hope you'll come and join me. If you've got any questions, you know, please, of course, do share them. Today we're going to be setting up my kube cluster again, and I say again because we previously had set up a kube cluster. It lived over, I think I've got a button. Let's see here. It lived over in this rack. Okay, it's not a very good shot of the rack right now. That's all right. We'll fix that up another time. But it lived over in the rack. Which is now a pile of stuff. But I moved it to a data center where it's got a proper upstream, multiple IP addresses, and all kinds of fun things like that. And we've actually got BGP set up on the router, which I'm super excited about, because that's been a lifelong goal since I was in high school, and I took my CCNA test back in high school. So, with that being said, let's get started. Actually, I think I need to update what it says here. Kube Adventures. Let's see if it switches. Yeah, I think it did. Okay. So yeah, we're gonna be setting up K3S again. And it's going to be all kinds of fun. So, on that note, let me get my terminal going. Ooh, why did my terminal launch Emacs by default? Oh no, did I set my default shell to Emacs? Oh no, I didn't. Okay. Good news. That seems like the kind of thing that Drunk Holden would do, and Drunk Holden has been around a little bit in pandemic times. Okay, colo scripts is where our scripts live. And we're gonna open it up. So I'll walk through what we've got so far. So there's the hosts file. Most of them are commented out right now because I was working on this last night. I was debugging experiment 626 wasn't a party. Hopefully we'll be able to debug this host first. And we'll do that. But these are the different hosts in the colo. So we've got, they're mostly named after characters from Lilo and Stitch. Anyways, and so you can see we've got the Kubernetes cluster, it's here. In the playbook section, there's the K3S install. There's also K3S remove because, like, I kept doing bad installs and I just wanted a quick remove script. So, on that note, I'm gonna put on a little bit of music because this is kind of weird not having any music. I like the music. CC0 music and player - shuffle startup. Cool. I'll get some more Creative Commons Zero license music later. Probably want line out built in audio. Let's go. Oh, Alexa, turn on speaker. Okay. There we go. So we got some chill music going. Got Emacs fired up. Okay, let's start with just running this because I don't actually remember what the error was from last time. Um Okay, so the first thing that it does, oh, actually experiment 626 worked just fine? That's weird. Because it was failing. But okay, that's all right. Let's re-enable. Oh, okay, actually, yeah, this host, I'm going to disable that for now. I need to go to the colo and reboot that host. But yeah, cool. So we'll run this on all of them, and this should give us a Kubernetes install of some type. Then after that, I would say the next thing that I want to do is start setting up sort of some of the basics on the cluster. So on that note, actually, let's see, Ansible, is there like Ansible Helm integration? Okay. Let's take a look at this collection. No. Okay. Let's go to the repo. Last commit 6 hours ago. 19 tags, 33 contributors. Okay, yeah, that's probably solid. Let's take a look at the docs for it. Okay. Yeah. Okay. That looks reasonable enough. Okay. Okay, cool. And so we, in theory, now we have a Kubernetes cluster. Let's interesting. So I'm not seeing the x86 nodes, the experiment 626 and experiment 624. So let's SSH to okay. Okay. Interesting. Interesting. So does this file exist? Let's take a look. It does not. Oh, this is why. This is probably, okay, yes, this explains some things are explained now. Host.yaml, okay. So I'm not actually installing. There is no special node label for this one. Well, actually, let me remember. Mount. Okay, yeah. LSBLK. Yeah. Okay. Probably okay. Well, they don't have GPUs in them, so and I also don't particularly care about this one. Okay, So then let's run that again. And now hopefully we'll actually have experiment 626 and experiment 624 join our cluster. And this is something that I care about because they have a lot of cores and some memory. Not. Not a perfect amount, but enough. Actually. Okay. So, yeah, we can get rid of that argument and run it. Okay, so, okay, so, okay. I need to go ahead and add this public key to the leader node. Okay, and then experiment 626. Do the same thing. Okay. Yep. Okay. I probably could automate that in Ansible, but I don't feel like doing that today. If I have to do this again, I should do that. Okay. Okay. Unable to. Okay, so Oh, that's weird. That's weird. Okay. Wait, what? Oh, am I misspelling experiment? Fucking hell. Yeah. Okay. Typos, not my strong suit. At least not how I spell experiment. Looks like how I spell experiment. Okay. This is the machine that I am SSH to, yes? Ah. Oh dear. This lies this yes, this is the problem. Okay. Typos, ahoy. Well, I guess it was DNS. So much fun. Okay. No laughing while I go to the workspace cloud. Okay. Cool. And chips. Very important part is snacks. Yes, always snacks. Okay. Every time I have to do my change my DNS settings in here, they've moved it on me. Normally. Cloud DNS. Until it's in the cloud because they said you. Aha. Sorry, emergency snack. Okay, so fixcomply.ca actions add DNS worker. Okay, so my problem is that I did not spell the domain names correctly. Okay. This is how we spell experiment, right? Let me double check. Yeah, okay. That is how we spell experiment. Okay, so experiment 624. We will go add experiment 624 with this IP address. Okay. Great. And then we'll do the same. This one. Okay. Okay. Sounds good. The next thing to do is fix the spelling here to match. Not that we have to because I didn't delete the old records, but you know. Be better if that worked. Okay. Okay. I forgot about DNS TTLs. Hey Bailey, and yeah, setting up the computers. So many computers. Yeah. So this is Ansible. But yes, don't worry. We can also get the very big JSON blobs from the Kubernetes. Mm. Alibissimo. So speaking of, while we're here, the next thing that I'm going to want to do is, oh yay, Mika here too. Wait, why is Mika not showing up in my chat? Okay, magic computer box. Magic computer box. Why is this not doing anything? Ah, what did it say? Host key verification failed. Okay. Experiment. Now that I spell it correctly, I can SSH to it, and then I can accept my host key. Yeah, okay. Yes. These make sense now. Okay. Meow! Yay, okay, yeah, I don't know. The chat view is just being weird. Because I was seeing in one place, but not in the other. Whatever. The K stands for quality in YouTube. Just making sure. Yeah, there's no K in YouTube. Okay, cool. So, we'll run this again. I think third or fourth time is the charm, and we will hopefully have all of the nodes in the cluster. And that'll make me very happy, because nodes in the cluster means happiness. Yes, I think so. This is true. Or close enough to true. Nodes in the cluster. Do-do. Yeah. How hot is it? Are you gonna go to the pool? This is good news. Oh no. Oh yeah, it has to be bidirectional SSH permissions, I think. Fudgesicles. Okay. Wait, there's no public key? Wait a second. That seems... Wait, Oh, no air conditioning sadness. That is the sad. Do I have SSH access to myself? I do! Solution! Carolyn, should I get it? Thank you! Okay. Oh, shave ice. I miss shave ice. Okay. Let's go ahead. Experiment 66. Okay, cool. So let's hope this works, right? Fourth time's the charm, maybe? Fourth time's the charm. But yeah, I mean, stuff is going okay here. I have my little doohickey thing for holding up the computer is not doing so great. So the other computer is just on the floor for now. One day I'll get like a fancy hanging thing for it. Actually, speaking of, I should probably just throw this out. Oh. Delicious, delicious scallop spaghetti. Okay, looks like I copied the wrong key. Ah. You know, actually, this is enough of a pain in the ass, I think. Actually, yeah, no, fuck it. Okay. Oh, cool. What's the new camera lens? Is it for looking at stars? Or like far, far away or close, close? That's reasonable. Money is fake, anyways. Hell, Satan. Delicious, delicious. Ooh, damn. Does it have like some self-stabilization stuff, or like how does it do its like meow meow? Or I guess maybe it's just like only on tripod times. Neat. I'm so excited to have my little. Oh. Damn it. Why is it still not working? Airplane pictures, fuck yeah. So this worked. Oh, did I like typo? To host them again? That's not the right host. Oh, no. What? Okay. So I can SSH in both directions. Right. That work. Yeah, airplane content. This is a host name, yes? Hmm. Let's see if we got experiment 624 in the meantime. Yeah! Fuck yeah. Okay. One more meow meow. Okay. Okay. The next thing is I'm gonna go to my own blog because I don't remember what I'm doing. Building the test cluster? Yes, maybe. Okay, no, this is about building the rack. What is next? Okay, no. Setting up to Kubernetes. Oh, okay. It looks like I did not write about how to do that part. That's unfortunate. I did write about this part. Okay. So, moderate solution. K3S, remote. Access. Yeah. Okay. Okay. So I'm going to drag my terminal over here and cat this so that I don't put my key in the internet. And I'm probably gonna need to do the same thing with my Emacs. Do. Oh, yes. Okay. And I suspect I'm actually going to run into a bunch of trouble now because this like actually has a host name instead of just an IP address. Oh, and I shared that password anyways. Well, fine. Okay, whatever. I'll just reinstall after this is all done, because we've got the script set up, so I hope no one does anything evil in the next like 15-20 minutes. Oh, sorry, I forgot to put myself on mute for the snacks. Wow. Okay. Well, oh yay, that's exciting. Magic snacks. Good. Okay. Okay, so this is the problem. Client certificate data. Yes. Remember, no being evil until I have a chance to reset everything. Ah. Yeah, so many things. Okay. Do. No being evil. Okay. Let's see if this works. Oh, interesting. It does. Okay, cool. So, that's fine. That worked. We're going to go ahead and... Oh, except... This is very confusing. It says unable to connect to experiment 626.pigsconfly.ca. Handshake failed. But like, I don't know why the handshake is failing. Because, like, as far as I can tell, like, this connection is fine. And sorry. Oh, maybe that is the one? That doesn't make sense though, because experiment 624 would also give us the same prompt. Yeah. Huh. I don't know. Okay. The good thing is though, I've got this K3S dash remove, or K3S, what is it? K3S remove. So we'll uninstall it, and that will remove the chance for people to be evil while I have a snack. Okay. So yeah, not surprisingly, experiment 66 is the one where uninstalling failed, but this makes sense given that installing on experiment 626 was failing. Okay. So let's try installing Kubernetes again. Kubernetes. Let's see here. Maybe I'm trying to think about other things that it could be. And I don't know. I do not know. What else would keep that bidirectional connection from happening? Like, why would K3 up fail? Well, we'll find out. At least we'll probably find out. Yes, this is the one with the terabyte of RAM. So I do want it to connect because this was my plan for this machine was going to be mostly like mostly things for things. Yes. Oh, yeah, this also has a 3.5 terabyte disk of nothingness right now. Yeah. Snook. Okay. Oh yeah, the stonks go to the moon! To the moon! I wonder how the game stonk is doing. I like the stonk. Damn it! Experiment 626 failed! Experiment 626! How? How is this failing? Okay. We will run this command, yes, and we will see what it does. Game stonk. Okay. Okay. So I'm gonna try this. Yes, I SSH there. Great success. I SSH back to experiment 626.pixelfly.ca. Great success. Game stonk. Don't go to the moon. They are very silly. I am slightly worried about, like, what the end game for all of this is. Because, like, I don't know. But, eh. Eh. Okay. Don't know why the join command isn't working. Like, SSH for experiment 626. Oh. Huh. Would that be a thing? That seems weird, but oh shit, that is a thing. Okay. Okay. I want to make a note to myself about this for next time. I don't know. Okay. What would I want to do? So there's, oh yeah, okay, over in ssh.yaml. So, to do, future, also, k3 sub join requires that root can SSH back to localhost. So add tilde slash dot SSH. Actually, yeah, whatever. Let's just do that now because, like, configure reflexive root SSH access. So I think I can actually specify like the file here, and I think it'll take the file from the host, but I could be wrong. What is Nyao? Oh, are they the ones with the thing? No, they're probably not the ones, because China. There's the one, the company that got the USPS contract. Is that them? Can I add? Okay. So here is the question. Is this lookup file gonna execute on? Well, I guess this will actually answer because like it's not like I have permission to read. SSH access for key. So, okay, let's try running that. Oh, okay. Typos. Somewhere. I don't. Oh, it's definitely missing a become. Okay. Donks. Oh, the stonk goes down. No. Stonk goes up. Stonk goes up. Oh, stonk goes down. Stonk need go up. Only up. Stonk go up. Yeah. Huh. Interesting. I guess they not. Have wait, that doesn't make sense. Not spell good? Oh wait, it's not home root, it's slash root. Silly Holden. Yeah, Ansible very unhappy with the stonks. Stonk. Stonk, 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 stonk. I shouldn't be allowed to invest money in the market, but I am, so that's hilarious. Okay. This is weird though, because that file totally does exist, right? Like, so I don't know. I don't know why the stonk is unhappy, right? Like, stonk sad. Oh, I guess, okay, Ansible. Look up file remote host. Here we go. Huh. What about? Okay, I guess Ansible Oh yeah, so I did. This is like doing lookup file, and so it looks like that's executing locally. So get everyone's public key. No, actually, I should just get everyone's public key. So, do do do. Except I don't want to. Okay, so ID RSA.pub come So it's looking in root on my local machine. It's not where I want it. I want it to be in the like remote meow meow. Oh, except instead of mounts. Remote keys. Let's find out. Remote keys. Yeah, I mean that seems like that could totally maybe do a thing. I don't actually want it in the repo. I just want it, so I want all of them to be able to SSH to each other, because the K3 scripts kind of assume that they can. Slightly more than I expected. I thought that they just assumed bidirectional with the leader, but it looks like it assumes slightly more than that. I can't spell, but progress, progress, progress. I think it's gonna work. Fingers crossed. Not a guarantee, but fingers crossed. I could totally see that. SSH forward agent. Yeah. So K3, sorry. K3 up is, let's bring it up. Alexa, stop. It's this like bootstrap thing. Well, it works in a bunch of places. It didn't work on some of them. Okay. Yeah. Okay, I remember now. How do I generate ID RSA pub from private key? There is no passphrase on this key. So, in theory, make everyone have a public key. Ansible.built in dot shell. And then what we'll do is we'll say that it creates root ID RSA dot pub. And come is true. Okay. So, I think this might work. I could be wrong. I'm gonna go check on Professor Timbit and change the laundry around. So we're gonna switch on the Timbit cam. Do 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 do. Oh no, the Timbit cam isn't working. Oh, okay, it is. Let me go find Professor Timbit. I'll be back.
Stop it. is it? Oh, it looks like a stick.
Do you have a stick? Does our little boy have a stick? Yeah!
No, that's not quite nice.
Okay.
Throw it out from your own template. With Professor Tintin. That's what you want for your own.
It looks like it mostly worked, but it didn't work on these three. And that's probably because they don't actually have SSH keys. I'm okay with that outcome for now. So actually what I'll do... is we're going to do this for just a subset of the hosts, because we only need that for the Kubernetes hosts. Oh, actually, you know what? Let's move this over to the Kubernetes one anyways. Because that's where we... get everyone's public key, There we go. So that's probably what we want to do anyways. And we'll do K3S remove, I think. That'll be fine. Okay. Now we'll install K3S. Okay, so it's installing the K3S leader right now. That looks like it was successful. So while that's running, I'm gonna cut this. I'm gonna do that off screen, and I'm hopefully not gonna fuck up and share the password again. Actually, huh. You know what I think I may have discovered is the uninstall script does not appear to quite uninstall quite as much as I thought it did. Either that or that's more deterministic than I expected. Or is it just a common prefix? Okay. Okay, they are different. There's just a lot of overlap. And presumably that's some like padding or something. Okay, that's fine. Okay, well, let's rerun the install. take a hot minute. Okay, running the KDS leader one. So now I should be able to get this, yeah. And then the certificate authority data. Okay. Now. Maximize. Okay, cool. Think I can avoid accidentally sharing my keys this time. Not a guarantee. Optimistic. Okay. So here we go. Go kubectl get nodes. Minus W. Actually, okay, yeah, it looks like we got the full set of nodes. That's kind of cool. Okay. So, the next question, which I don't know for sure what I want to do here, is... Actually, yeah, you know what? Okay. I want to take a look at the... Oh, yeah, because MinIO has changed how it's deployed. I want to see if MinIO is cross-built for ARM on Linux just yet, because I would rather... not have to customize it. That does not look super solid. Okay. Just show me MinIO? I just want to see the MinIO containers. Ah, here we go. Okay. Let's take a look. No. Okay, so the releases are cross-built. Edge is not. I think that's okay. Latest is cross-built too. Okay. So I think we should be fine using the MinIO operator to deploy. So... or the MinIO Helm chart, which it's changed since the last time. MinIO Helm chart. Okay. This has changed, and they now want this to be deployed. Okay. So then from Ansible. Well, this is starting to feel... Yeah, okay. Helm. Okay. So, okay, yeah. So we'll go ahead and we'll add this to this. This isn't a role, this is a collection. Okay. Maybe it's a role. Community.kubernetes? Sure. Let's take a look. Maybe this one. What? Yes? Okay, I guess it's already installed. Sounds good. Yeah. Yeah, Bailey and Mika were here for a while. I think they went to go do other things though, because like. Yeah, that's fine. Mew.
Sun's coming in.
Yeah, door closed is fine. It's all good. Okay. So the Helm chart that I want to add.
Because you were being a little shit.
Oh no, Bailey's still here. And Mika's still here. So they're both still here.
Do they want to see our little asshole?
He's not an asshole.
He is a Digasaurus.
Okay.
What did I just step on?
Possibly.
Oh, it's nice. It's okay.
Possibly. Oh. Okay,
He's
let's
so
go into
dirty.
talking mode. There we go. It'll update in a second.
I love you,
Professor.
buddy.
I love our
Look
little
how dirty
professor.
his face.
Oh, did you shove this face somewhere good? Did you shove this face somewhere good?
Repeatedly.
That's why you have an outdoor cone. That's why you have an outdoor cone.
And when do we're in bed?
Outdoor cone for
I'm
the
so
perimeter.
glad there's one over in
It's not just his indoor cone?
bed.
It's his bedtime cone. Okay, should I get him a third cone?
No, it can be his indoor cone if he's staying inside for a while, yeah. And I'm not like immediately watching him.
More professor.
Because this one he can get to his, if he wants to.
Yeah, where your Skittles and Bits used to be.
Where his stitches are. Which, like.
Bailey says hi.
Hi, baby. Which one is the camera? Is it this one?
This one is a camera. This one is a camera for hangouts.
Oh, they look crazy.
Yeah.
Meow, meow.
Oh, we have a little puppy. Which is to say, he does not want to be here anymore. He would much rather go explore. Is it okay if I put him back down? Good job, Professor. Enjoy your exploration. Okay. So I'm gonna go back. Oh yeah, feel free to take some of the chips and guac if you want. Yeah. I'm just gonna go love you. One day maybe we'll all get to hang out again together. Okay. How do I actually? I guess I would run this. On the leader because I don't. Okay. Professor Soros does not understand or care, but that's okay. Okay. Where did it go? I thought I had the... Okay, yeah. Yeah. Admin IO chart. So... Ah. Actually, I think I'm going to separate this out into, like, this is... cluster setup dot YAML. Sure. Oh, the name. I think the name is just Minio, and the repo URL is... Do. Yeah, maybe I'm wrong. We'll find out. Or is there a way to run Ansible run locally? Run task locally. I mean, whatever. Yes, that's fine. We can run it remotely. Sorry. Pardon me. I will be right back after that sneeze. What was I doing? Okay, yeah. So then we go, K3S leader, yeah. Strangely enough, actually, yeah. So, cluster setup, that YAML. Let's run this and see what happens. Okay. It's a failure. That's not it. Is it the comment? No, that wouldn't make sense. No, okay. I feel like that's saying... that this isn't... Oh, hey, buddy. Oh. No? Okay. You know what? Fuck it. Let's just grab this. Yeah? No. Line things up with that. Name, and then repo. Yeah, okay. Something tells me it didn't actually install this collection. Okay. Oh, well. Sounds like progress of a sort. Okay. Install Helm. Yeah, it's not like this is any different. Swap Helm with okay. No, oops. Fuck yeah. Okay. And we'll install the MinIO operator, which is, I guess everything has to be an operator these days. I don't remember why everything needs to be an operator. That's okay. I hear you, buddy. You're pissed off. Professor Saurus, not very happy. Okay. So, yeah. Let's go ahead and switch this over. Okay. Oh, except I also want to figure out where it installs Helm. That's where it installs Helm. Great. And then... deploy chart reference. It's going to be minio/minio. Namespace is minio. Operator? Or wait, is that the chart names? Oh, let me double check which chart is where it's talking. Okay. Namespace, Mineo, operator. Helm install. Wait. Oh, Okay, yeah. Minayo dash. Minayo slash Minayo dash operator. Okay. Run this, see what we get. Weird. Installing Helm. Yes. There's nothing else left, I remember, right? Okay. And so now, if I run this, yes. Okay, kubectl get nodes. Works fine. I don't know. Okay. Why is it trying to connect to port 8080? Okay. Let's say I run the same command here. Gonna work. This is gonna need. I think. Well, let's try it. Okay. That might actually do the trick then? Okay. Helm repo ls. Helm. Repo del minio. helm repo remove minio. Okay. Okay, so it is trying to run helm upgrade. Okay, the release is latest. Minio operator, I think. Okay. So, I need to create namespace. That's what the error was. Create. Call it. Okay, so that gives us the minio operator. The thing that I don't know what I want to do right now is whether or not I want to install Rook and Ceph. Or if I just want to install now this is coming back to me. How do I want to install Minio? Do I want to use Rook and Ceph? There's part of me which wants to use Rook and Ceph. There's another part of me which doesn't want to because it was, like, kind of a pain in the ass last time. And just wants to use host paths with Minio. Because, like... But, you know what? It might be nice to have persistent volumes... Yeah, we've already got the stuff, I think, to do a Rook Ceph install. So let's explore doing that, I think. Let's see if the crap Rook Ceph ARM 64 is this like actually done? Okay, it sounds like, in theory, this is just supposed to work now. No, I don't want to use Raspberry Netties. Hmm. I'm suspicious of things that are supposed to work because they didn't before. Oh, yay. Yay, sloppy code. Okay. Okay. Take a look at what the rook releases are, because it sounds like it should be working in 1.5, which was 1.5.9 was released 9 days ago. So maybe the stuff will just work. Not holding out hope, but like rook Ceph Helm, maybe? I don't know. Do I want to do it with a helm chart? So, okay, let's go take a look at the quick start. Yeah, so like this is the thing. I want to be able to configure what the nodes are. Yeah, so the nodes here. Yeah, I want to configure the devices. But, not, I don't see that option. Let's take a look. Device? No. Okay. Not. No. Okay. I mean, this looks honestly like okay, yeah. Let's try it. You know, why not? Add Rook Ceph chart. Namespace that we want to use is rook dash ceph, and the chart reference that oh wait, no. Okay, oh, this is the install. Okay, that's why my brain isn't. This, yeah, okay. Do, 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 do. Okay. Okay. Release. The repo URL is here. Okay. Deploy Rooksaf. Okay. So the name, not very imaginative, is Rooksaf. Release Rooksaf. And then okay. That looks kind of like what I want. Yeah, no. Yeah. Well, let's try it. Let's see what happens. Yeah. Scripts. Okay. Let's find out. Okay. So the operator's been installed. Solid. So there we go. Okay. Let's get the namespaces. Get all-n, minio operator. Saf. Okay. Let's see, solid, yeah. So I think the next thing that we want to do after this is gonna be what is it? My brain. Configure staff cluster. Yeah? Okay. Great. So for that, it's not. Oh, yeah, it's in the make hits cluster one. And we don't need the operator. It's. Oh, okay. Cool. Alexa, stop. Okay, you know what? It's about 7 o'clock at night. We've got this pretty far along the way. Like we've got a cluster. We don't have MinIO or Ceph configured yet. But I kind of want to make dinner. So we're gonna do that, and I'm gonna go switch laundry around. And then maybe after dinner I might do more streaming, or I might just like kind of hack this out on my laptop on the couch while we watch garbage television. Friday night. You want to watch garbage TV tonight? Do you want to watch it together, or should I do more stream after dinner?
You're getting up right now?
Sure. Let me figure out how to stop the stream first.
Okay.
Yeah. I guess thanks everyone for joining. I really appreciate it. Especially Bailey and Mika. I hope the two of you get to meet in person someday. But it was nice having people around for chat.